Hello students, welcome back to the class. In this class, one topic from uncertainty in measurements is left, that is dimensional analysis. See, now we are not while doing calculation, we have to convert one system to another system. Sometimes kg in the gram, right? Or inch in the centimeter. ಅಥವಾ ಟೂ ಡೇಸ್ ಇದೆ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಅದನ್ನ ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಗೆ ಕನ್ವರ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಅಂತ ಕೇಳ್ತಾರೆ. ಈ ತರ ಕೇಳಿದಾಗ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಫಾಲೋ ದ ಮೆಥಡ್, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಕ್ಯಾಲ್ಕುಲೇಟಿಂಗ್. ಬೈ ಕ್ಯಾಲ್ಕುಲೇಟಿಂಗ್ ದರ್ ಇಸ್ ಆನ್ ನೀಡ್ ಟು ಕನ್ವರ್ಟ್ ದ ಯೂನಿಟ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಒನ್ ಸಿಸ್ಟಮ್ ಟು ಅನದರ್. ದ ಮೆಥಡ್ ಈಸ್ ಯೂಸ್ಡ್ ಅಕಂಪ್ಲಿಶ್ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಫ್ಯಾಕ್ಟರ್ ಲೇಬಲ್ ಮೆಥಡ್ or unit factor method or dimensional analysis. So let us take one example. See, convert a metal piece which length is 3 inch, it is given in inch. Convert into centimeter. 3 inch and a centimeter convert. Before that, ನಿಮಗೆ 1 inch ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಎಷ್ಟು ಸೆಂಟಿಮೀಟರ್ ಅಂತ ಗೊತ್ತಿದೆ. ಸೊ 1 inch which is equal to 2.54 centimeter. This is the exact value, 2.54 centimeter. So now I will write one relation. Relation means, see, 1 inch which is equal to 2.54 centimeter, right? 1 inch and 2.54 centimeter and 1, which is equal to 1. See, this is unit factor. Why? See, idanne illu tekkondre anything which is multiplied into 1, it is this value only. So I take from this to here, one and the same, right? So which is equal to 2.54 centimeter divided by 1 inch. One and the same, because illi 1 inch idana nan illi tekkondre, so illi left agirodu 1 unit. Now you have to understand this step. See, 1 inch divided by 2.54 centimeter, which is equal to 1. In any other, it is 1, right? So it is equal to 2.54 divided by 1 inch. Now you have to convert 3 inch into centimeter. See, by calculating, you have to consider either this or this. So which one we have to consider for calculation? This one. Why? Centimeter is in numerator. I mean, centimeter convert. So 3 into 2.54 centimeter divided by 1 inch. This unit factor. This factor is for using the calculation. Now, what is the answer? 4 into 3. 12, 1. Then 5 into 3, 15, 16. Then 7.62 centimeter. So 3 inch is equal to 7.62 centimeter. Like this, we have to convert one system to another system. Now convert one more example. Convert 2 days into seconds. ಎರಡು ದಿನ ಅಂತ ಎಷ್ಟು ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ಸ್ ಅಂತ ಕೇಳಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್, ಯು ನೋ ದಟ್ ಒನ್ ಡೇ ವಿಚ್ ಇಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು 24 ಅವರ್, ರೈಟ್? which is equal to 1. Same like this one. One day is equal to 24 hours. 24 hours na nilivadu. Which is equal to 24 hour divided by 1 day. One and the same, right? Then you have to convert. So 2 day means it is 48 hours. So hour na convert. So 1 hour which is equal to 60 minutes, right? That is equal to 1 and 60 minutes divided by 1 hour, right? Next, 1 minute which is equal to 60 second, that is equal to 1 60 second which is divided equal to 1 minute. One and the same, right? These three relations, one and the same. Now, 2 days is that, right? 2 into, you have to consider this one, right? 24 divided by 1, not required, because it's divided by 1 or 24 is one and the same. Then into 60 minutes. This relation we have to take. Converted into seconds, right? Second power will be in the numerator, right? So 60 minutes into 60 seconds. So the total multiply by. So 1728,000 seconds. That means 1,72,800 second. 2 days andre 1,72,800 seconds. This is the method to convert one system to another system. Understand? Coming to our next topic, that is stoichiometry. Stoichiometry thus deals with the calculation of masses, sometimes volume also, of the reactant and the product involved in the chemical reaction. So let us consider one reaction. This is methane. Here gas is there, means it is in the gaseous state. This in subscript we have to write gaseous in bracket. Oxygen, it will give carbon dioxide CO2 in the gaseous form and water, right? See, these two are the reactants, right? Then here whether the reaction is balanced, no, right? Here 3 oxygen is there, here 2 is there, so we have to balance the equation by 2, total 4, and here also 4, right? Now the equation is balanced, carbon 1, carbon also 1. So these 2 are coefficients. Stoichiometry just deals with the calculation of masses of the reactant and the product involved in a chemical reaction. Then this arrow mark indicates the reaction indicates the direction of reaction. Sometimes the arrow mark like this. This is reversible reaction. Direction both forward and backward reaction. This is only one side, direction of the reaction. This arrow mark indicates the direction of the reaction. And these two are products. CO2 and H2O are the products. Understand? Now, what is the coefficient here? See, CH4, methane. One molecule of methane and two molecules of oxygen reacts with one molecule of carbon dioxide and two moles of water. Here one not written, right? So not written means it's only one. So one molecule of CH for methane, add two molecule of oxygen, it will give one molecule of carbon dioxide and two molecule of water. One mole of methane reacts with two mole of oxygen, which will give one mole of carbon dioxide and two mole of water. Or in other words, we can represent it in liter also. And one more term is, we can represent it in terms of mass, gram, right? CH4 means 12 plus 4, 16 gram of CH4 reacts with O2, oxygen. It is total 2 is there, right? So now here it is 16 4s are. So it is 44 gram of oxygen reacts with. You have to calculate the masses of product individually. These three meaning are three are the same, gives same meanings. This is about the stoichiometry of a chemical reaction. Let us solve some of the numericals, then you can understand easily. Let us see the numericals first. Calculate the amount of water produced by the combustion of 16 gram of methane. So what is given here? Here given 16 gram of methane. We have to calculate the amount of water produced by the combustion of 16 gram of methane. So first we have to write the balanced chemical equation. For combustion of methane, the balanced chemical equation is CH4 is in the gaseous state, which is react with oxygen. Combustion in the sense, it is always reacts with O2, which gives, which is also in the gaseous form, carbon dioxide and water, H2O. So this is not balanced now. So we have to balance the equation. Why? It is here only one oxygen is there, here two is there. So we have to balance the equation. Now it is 4H, here also 4, and 2O, O2, and here 3 is there. So 3 plus 4, 4 is there. So here also 2. This is the balanced chemical equation. So now we have to calculate the amount of water produced by the combustion of 16 gram of methane. So 1 mole of CH4 means methane, will gives here 2 mole of water, right? In the equation we have to concentrate on methane and H2O. Other are not required because in the question not given. So 1 mole of CH4 will give 2 mole of H2O. So what is the mass of CH4? That means mass of methane, that is 16 gram, right? Carbon 12 plus 4, it is 16. So now mass of 2 mole of H2O, we have to calculate. So 2 into H2O, it is oxygen 16 atomic mass, and 2, 16 plus 2, it is 18. So that is equal to 36. 36 gram. This is the amount of water is produced after the produced by the combustion of 16 gram of methane. The second question is, how many moles of methane are required to produce 22 gram of carbon dioxide after combustion? The equation is same. First you have to write the chemical equation, that is balanced chemical equation. Methane reacts with oxygen and give carbon dioxide and water,
and then you have to balance the chemical equation. Then see, this question is not like the previous question. Here you have to find out how many moles of methane are required to produce 22 gram of carbon dioxide, that is CO2. CO2 is the product. 22 gram of CO2 is produced after the reaction. For that purpose, methane, how many moles required? That one we have to find out. See, 1 mole of methane, and which is 1 mole of CO2, right? Here 1 mole is there. Here also in methane side also, 1 mole of methane will give 1 mole of carbon dioxide. So 1 mole of methane which give carbon dioxide, how many grams? It is 44 gram. Why it is 44? Oxygen 2, 16 plus 16, 32 plus 12, it is 42. CO2, 12 plus 16 into 2, that is equal to 44 gram. So 44 gram of CO2, that is carbon dioxide. So how many gram produced? It is 22 gram. 22 gram of CO2 is produced. So how many moles of methane is required? So that is cross multiplication. How to do this one? 22 into 1 divided by 44. That is half. That is equal to 0.5 mole of methane is required to produce 22 gram of CO2, carbon dioxide, after the combustion. 0.5 mole of methane is required. This is the solution of this problem.